Hi, this is Anne with SVG Cut File, and today I'm going to show you how to use a mockup that you may have gotten online in Canva. And we're going to add a design to a shirt mockup in this tutorial. All right, let's get started. First thing we'll do is go to canva.com. I do want to say that you will need to sign up for an account with Canva if you don't already have one, but that account is free and then you have access to all these cool tools. And they do have like an upgraded version, but for most of the things you'll need to do, including this tutorial, you won't need to pay for Canva. Okay, so I'm already logged in. I'm just going to come up here to create a design. And I'm going to choose custom dimensions. I'm planning on making an Instagram image, so I'll make it 1080 by 1080. And we'll create new design. Now I'll come over here to uploads. And I'll click this purple button to upload my media. And I'm going to get this from my device. Now I'm going to navigate to where my mockup is. If you just download it, it'll probably be in your downloads, which are usually right over here if you're on a PC. If you're on a Mac, you'll want to hit Option Command L to jump to your downloads. But mine is saved in a different folder, so I'll just navigate there and choose Open. Now it might take a second, depending on how fast your internet is, but it'll put the design here under Images. Then we can just click and drag this onto our canvas. I'm going to move it up a little bit and then just get on a corner to resize it. I'm going to make it fill the entire canvas, so part of it won't be showing, but that's okay with me. I'm just going to move it over a little bit, center it up in the frame, maybe move it up a little bit. Okay, and this looks good. So now my mockup is on my canvas. I've also already downloaded a PNG file with a transparent background, and this is something that's really important. It needs to be a transparent background so the part of the shirt can kind of show through. So I'll come up here to upload media, and then I'll go to device again. And here is my transparent background PNG file. Now, if you don't have a PNG file, this is something that the designer can provide for you. In my Etsy shop, I always provide a transparent background PNG file along with a couple other file types that are useful to a crafter. Okay, so I'm just going to come over here to open, and it's going to do the same thing. It might take a second to get in there. And then I'm just going to click on this and drag it over onto my canvas too. And it probably will come in pretty big, but that's okay. We can always grab a corner and just resize it to whatever size we need. And this looks pretty good. Now we can move it around a little bit. We can come down here and rotate it to match our background. And right now the black is very strong, so I'm going to come up here to the transparency and just kind of make it a little less strong so it looks like it goes with the picture a little better. Okay, that looks good. Now, if you wanted a different color for your PNG file, there are actually resources out online that you can change the color of your PNG files. So all you would need to Google is change PNG file color, and you should come up with a few options. So our mockup is ready to go with the design we placed on it. So now we can come up here to download. And we have a few different options. We can change our size here. I usually just leave this as PNG, but you can also make a JPEG or a PDF. If you had something that needed a transparent background or you wanted to compress the file, you would have to pay for Canva. So I don't ever do that. We'll just go ahead and download. And when we do that, it'll come right down here to the lower left corner. If you're using Chrome, if you're using a different browser, it'll probably go up to a different location, maybe up here in the corner. So anyway, we can click on this little caret and choose Show in Finder or Show in, I think, Window or maybe Explorer. It'll take us on our system to where it downloaded the design. Now we can upload this image to any platform we want, Instagram, Facebook, or wherever you sell or market your designs or products. And it's as easy as that. All right, if you have any questions, please leave those in the comments section below. And if you like this video, please click on the like button. I'll see you next week in another SVG Cut File tutorial. Thank you.